The Minister of Interior, Ogbeni Rafu Aregbesola, has charged newly decorated CG of Correctional Services, Haliru Nabada, to fish out bad eggs who smuggle prohibited items to inmates and assist them in running criminal operations while in custody. Aregbesola also charges Nabada to lead gallant officers of the service to protect integrity of the facilities using all means necessary. He said, "No one attacking our facilities should have the opportunity to regret his or her action. Others should do so on their behalf."
Well, I be a deputy commandant general and commandant general inaugurated here last week. And in my charge to them, I was unmistakable. I'm quite clear on what their mission to be. Charge them to make a big difference. The title of my speech here this afternoon is Grow Your Feet, and it's important. I'll give you a couple. Grow your feet in a big shoe. You don't get to a higher office with a feet that is up to the size of the shoe you are about to wear. Were you to have that certain type of feet or that size of feet before, then there's no need promoting you. It's because the shoe that you are about to wear, you have just worn now, is bigger than your size. That's why you are just stepping into it. So you must grow your feet to fit the new big shoe we have given to you. So the title of my speech, grow your feet in a big shoe. But you don't have much time to grow it. You are not like a toddler that takes forever to grow. You know, the toddler is totally helpless at birth, totally helpless at birth. Helpless that if not for women, if men were to take care of children, so many of them will not survive. You didn't laugh? If men, the nature of men, if all men are like me, and they are to nurse babies. So many of them will die. I don't have the patience, not even the physical form to handle babies. The way they are so totally helpless. All they do is to cry. The women are so conditioned, both physiologically, psychologically, and spiritually, to nurse babies. So we are not talking of that type of kind. Before a baby becomes somebody people will appreciate, he or she will have been 3 years old. You don't have 3 years to grow your feet. You must grow that feet within 2 hours. Your feet must grow before we leave this hall. Yes. So you must grow that feet. But whatever means, to fit your shoe in the period you're going to take for this ceremony. So grow your feet in a short. Grow your feet in a big shoe. It gives me great pleasure to be gathered here with you to perform this symbolic, the solemn task of decorating our brother, friend, and colleague, Ali Runababa, as the Controller General of the Nigerian Correctional Service. Nababa emerged from a rigorous, and I want to repeat, a rigorous meritocratic selection process devoid of interference from any quarters. I'm happy a few of those who participated in this are here to either deny or confirm our assertion. Was that after recommended by the board to President Muhammadu Buhari, who promptly nominated him for confirmation to the Senate of the National Assembly? Having been screened by the Nigerian Senate, and found worthy of its high responsibility was confirmed as the Controller General, and he is receiving today the mantle of the dog. I do not have a congratulations. Mr. Nababa is a gallant officer and a patriot. He has diligently served the country through the Nigerian Correctional Service for the past 31 years. The celebration is therefore well earned. Interestingly, his mounting is scheduled at a time of unusual security challenges. These are manifested in insurgency in the northeast, banditry in the northwest and parts of the north central, kidnappings in virtually all parts of Nigeria, financial crimes and ritual killing in the southwest, militancy that is assuming an insurrectional dimension in the southeast and south south, and sundry other criminal activities in all parts of Nigeria. The implication of this is that the custodial facilities will be bursting at the seams with the influx of inmates awaiting trials and convicts serving terms and awaiting execution. This poses a special challenge in that some of the inmates belong to organizations and groups that will deem themselves to be fighting an ethno, religious, and political causes. Therefore, their members outside will be planning to break into the facility to free their members. There are also sophisticated criminal organizations whose members are either serving terms or awaiting trials and are now using the security situation in the country as an opportunity to attack our custodial centers and obtain their freedom. Whatever may be the motive, custodial centers have been under consistent attack in the bravery challenge to the authorities of the Nigerian state. When inmates break free from custody, security of lives and property is in jeopardy, and bad things happen consequently. This is the sociology of your imagining as the Controller General of the Nigerian Correctional Service. It is therefore a call to leadership, sacrifice, patriotism, and selflessness. It is a bonding duty to lead the gathered officers and men of the service to protect the integrity of our facilities using all means necessary. No hold is barred. All means necessary to protect the integrity of our popular facility. No one attacking our facility could have the opportunity to regret his or action. This is seminal to this land. No one attacking our facilities should have the opportunity to regret his or her action. No. Others should do so on their behalf. I want to repeat that line for the third time. It was very, very important. You can quote me. No one attacking our custodial facilities to have the opportunity to regret his or her action. Others should do so on their behalf.
Gbemiga Olamikan reporting for GTV Africa.